Hey guys, today I'm going to show it to you. Whether you are a new homeschooler, whether you are on this channel and you don't even homeschool at all, or whether you have homeschooled for years and years and years, there is one thing we all have in common. We want to see inside each other's spaces, so I'm going to show it to you, all the places. Here's the thing, I don't really have a designated homeschooling room. So where do we homeschool? We homeschool everywhere. You know how they say the world is our stage? Well, this home is our room. We utilize every part of it. And when you walk into this house, you will know learning goes on, and you will know that this is a homeschooling family. So let's start the tour. In this tour of all the spaces where the magic happens, I want to inspire you to think outside the box. Homeschool does not have to look just like school. In fact, in our family, we prefer it that way. Homeschooling is a way of life, and when you enter this home, there's a little piece of classroom everywhere. So if you're thinking that in order to homeschool, you need a dedicated schoolroom, I am here to tell you, you don't. We had a dedicated space our first year. I had cute tables set up with whiteboards, a dedicated bookshelf, and all the cute homeschool things in my basement. It was our little dedicated schoolroom. We were going to do all the learning down there while my toddler entertained herself on the floor and never interrupted. I quickly found that anytime I had to leave that space, whether it was to tend to the toddler, start lunch, or even just let the dog out, my young children would inevitably get off track, and it was such a chore to get them back into the learning frame of mind. I also found during that first year that we didn't even want to stay in that space for all the learning anyway. We moved all over the house, inspired by Dr. Seuss. I could teach them here or there. I could teach them anywhere. Now, I'm not saying that you shouldn't set up a designated room. If I had a room on my first floor, I might do that. But my dining room needs to work for both school and when we have guests over. And what kind of space you should set up also depends on your own family dynamics. If you have an older child, they may need a quiet space to get away from the littles. My son does his math online. He does his Latin DVDs in the basement. And he also has a desk in his room if he needs quiet away from the girls. I even send my daughter up to her bedroom sometimes. She has ADHD, so sometimes she needs to be alone so she can focus. So she gets sent upstairs to her bedroom with her homework so she can do just that. We also utilize our breakfast table. If mama needs one-on-one time with a child while the others work in the dining room, this is where we come. And sometimes the kids do work at the kitchen island while I clean up or need to tackle this huge pile of clean dishes. Unfortunately, there are no kitchen fairies in this house to come and magically clean it up while I teach. Are there kitchen fairies in your house?
No, that's not part of school, Mother.
So let's go look at the dining room and how we use it for our school. And also, I will show you how I clean it up for when guests come over. So I've been waiting to shoot this video till this room looked nice and clean and perfect, but is that ever gonna happen? No, it's not. So we are going to do this. So I have a portable whiteboard right here. It can fold up. I actually don't use it a whole lot because I have small portable whiteboards and we just use paper. So I try to purchase furniture that could double as kind of dining room storage pieces. I got these cabinets from IKEA and I got them specifically because I have a lot of dishes that only come out if we're entertaining, but I wanted everything to be behind closed doors that I needed to store for homeschooling. Hidden. I do not like visual clutter. So these baskets are housing some supplies, but at least they're hidden away in the baskets. And so this is kind of what I call my language arts bin, and then this book. This is probably still some visual clutter to some, but I feel like at least their books are in these magazine files. I can still see some clutter here. See?
This, right there. That needs to be turned around.
So this is where the kids keep their everyday assignments. So that way they can look somewhat neat when they're not in use. Everything that's in the glass doors is in these large bins. These are actually like cardboard bins from IKEA. And then this box is probably like a 13 by 13 cube. And a turntable in here for that big art project that they want to do. And an old gallon. And then extra, all kinds of paintbrushes and just, you know, art supplies. Paint, art supplies that I don't want them to just pull out whenever they want. And then if we have a need to put things in binders, we have these. And then there's puzzles in there. This rolling cart, mobile. It's obviously a mobile cart. If we need to move to another room, we can grab our magazine files. We can put them up here and move to another room. I also have this handy thing. If I just want to take this and move things to another room, then I can do that as well. I have to have these mats on my table, one to protect my table, which already has been scratched up.
Or should I say, has already had memories made on it from my dear sweet children.
So this protects the table further, but it also helps it create a flat writing surface since it has ridges. Next time I go to IKEA, I'm going to get clean ones. This one has been well loved, has some paint on it. We could probably get this off if we really tried, but if you homeschool at a big table like this, I highly, highly, highly recommend getting this. This has been revolutionary to our homeschool space because I used to house like all the markers in completely different containers and maybe stored away, and anytime we needed them, we had to go to the place to go get them. So instead, we just put all the school supplies as much as we can here. It's actually fairly organized. The big things in the middle, but like crayons, pencils, pens, and dry erase markers. We don't really keep that many markers here because the dog, she can jump on the table when we are gone, and she loves to chew on the markers, as you can see. So we had to put some of those in a different place.
You need to stop.
School mascot. These also are magnetized on the back. So that's kind of cool. They won't, if you're picking it up, they're not going to just slide out. And then we always have coasters because if they bring drinks in here, protect mama's table, please. I got this at Paula Deen's store in Tennessee. So cute. And over in this corner are more things from IKEA. The cube shelf is from IKEA. These trays are from IKEA. I put daily math drills or daily writing prompts here just for extra practice. This is an antique container that I've had forever, and I decided to finally put it to use for the small supplies. And then in these crates, which I got from TJ Maxx, are my teacher's manuals and anything that I need to keep track of. This chest and drawer also houses stuff, not really homeschool stuff, but maybe coloring books or things like that, activity books that if we're going on a road trip, I want to grab quickly. It holds some extra, see, this is a travel journal, some extra markers and extra dry erase. My dog, she finds the funniest places to just lay down. This fan is a must have because in a dining room, you don't have a fan. You have a chandelier, and sometimes on hot days, we need a fan. So I bought this cute little thing from TJ Maxx. It adds just enough. This Bluetooth speaker is also a must-have because we play classical music sometimes when we're trying to put our head down and work. Mm-hmm. is put away. Sort of, I actually have a specific spot for it. So this is as tucked away as it really gets, unless I have space to put it someplace else. There's a mirror back there that's not normally there, but since we just painted. This container moved over here to this table, so it's out of the way. The table mats. The table would have a centerpiece if I had guests over. And the mats I took off, and they just kind of tuck over here in the corner with these other boards. And that's how I clean up if guests are coming, so that I have a dining room space. Although this dining room looks like it's our main homeschooling room, it really isn't. We probably spend more time in all of the other rooms combined. We maybe even spend more time in the living room than in here. The living room is where we start our morning. It's where we do what we call morning time, and I'll talk more about that in my next video, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss it. We also do any memory work in here, as well as reading.
Like you.
This is a spot that currently just has our little first day of school banner, but we have used this before to hang up memory work, timeline cards, artwork. I have underneath my fireplace mantle a little ledge here, so I put these little command strips that are very handy and can be hidden. They're really handy at Christmas time too. And hang ornaments from them. So I just hung a bunch of little hooks there so we can have a string and display some of our school things. On nice days, we might take some schoolwork to the porch or even to our outside tables. Quiet reading time is always more fun outside. So perfect spot for finding a cozy little place in the grass to do some reading. What you reading?
The Babysitter's Club.
How is it?
It's good. Christy sounds a little selfish. It was my idea.
That's teenagers for you. So you read and you learn what not to do. How do they honor God? Or how could they have honored him better? The grass is nice and cushy.
Sure.
You should have set up your blanket underneath the tree in the shade over there. Yeah, get some sunbathing in.
Sure.
Here's a tip for sunbathing. Don't wear long pants. Let's go see what you're doing. You're reading out here. Oh, I can't see you very good. Oh, wait. Through the screen. There we go. Is this a fun spot to read?
Yeah. You know what I can do?
What?
I'm reading. I can jump up and down and do this.
I don't think you can do that while you're reading.
Yes, I can. See? This?
All right. Why don't you just lay down and read?
Our teacher taught us how to sing a very lovely song. We sing and sing with us. And we'll sing of God.
And of course, any educational DVDs or educational YouTube videos are watched in the basement on our largest TV. This is also where we gather around for our gather around units. We get nice and cozy on the couch and cast the teacher's manual onto the smart TV so we can all see the pictures clearly. And then it's very handy to be here, so if our unit does suggest a video, we can pull it up right away. Learning literally happens everywhere with this family. All corners of this house have blessed our learning, as well as the great outdoors. When we decided to homeschool, my husband was inspired by Deuteronomy 6:5-9. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. These words which I'm commanding you today shall be on your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your sons, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house.
Give thanks to the Lord, call upon his name, make known his deeds among the peoples. Sing to him, sing praise.
And when you walk by the way, and when you lie down and when you rise up. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontals on your forehead. You shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates.
So our space is all over our home. We homeschool in the living room, in the basement, in the dining room, on the porch, outside, while we're walking, in the kitchen.
So yes, as inspired by the Bible, our Christian homeschool doesn't happen in just one room.
This is part one of a series of videos that I'm going to be doing all about homeschool organization. So if you want to see those videos, remember to hit subscribe.
We want to see inside each other's spaces.
So in this video, I am going to show you all the places where the magic happens. Oh, man. That wasn't very magical. So in this video, I'm going to show you all the places where the magic happens.
Yeah. Well, I guess the magic just isn't meant to be.
Remember to hit subscribe and hit that bell so you will be notified when those are ready. And I'll see you next time. Bye.